My whole life, I've always felt like an outsider. I've never really quite fit in. And whether it was just that I was different from other people, or even, you know, the adversity of sometimes being Mexican American and being able to have the confidence to be myself and to accept who I was, because you know, sometimes there is a lot of adversity when it comes to those things.
Mortified, fortified, feeling like a Mordecai. I ain't regular, feel like Jordan wearing 45. Traumatized, victimized, seen some of my niggas die. Knock you off a base with a bat when them niggas slide. Homicide, genocide, televised, emphasize, perpetuating war. Tell that nigga he gon' be beside. Hood ties my hood lines, my niggas doing dope lines. I'm running to the cops, that's a bitch, nigga exercise. Don't run into the cops, that's the motto. I don't see it coming to an end like Legato.
So I never really got along with people the way that I always like hoped that I would in life. I went to high school in Glen Ellen, which is like primarily, you know, it's a very affluent neighborhood. So a lot of the people didn't look like me, and that was kind of hard to like resolve and understand for me. I did experience a lot of bullying, you know, primarily in middle school and a little bit into high school. I don't think I ever realized how much of an impact that had on me, you know, as a child, as a teenager. My whole life, I've never done what one would consider like traditional sports. So I actually really didn't play any sports growing up. I was terrible at baseball. I was terrible at football, basketball, really any ball sports. But then I got into boxing. Boxing was phenomenal for me. It gave me that outlet to be able to like take out my aggressions and my frustrations and like everything that was bothering me, and like once again put it into you know, a format that allowed me to like be a better person and to grow. Because otherwise, I mean, honestly, like I could have gone down a really bad path, you know, whether it was into kind of like, you know, gang-related stuff, or, you know, I also had a problem with alcohol and drinking from a very young age, you know, 13 years old to like about like 20, 21. So it really kept me away from that, and it gave me more time to do something like more productive. And during that time, like, I really honestly think that if I wasn't boxing, I don't know what path I would have led down, because I was being very reckless and I wasn't taking care of myself, and I wasn't being, you know, caring towards others and or anybody. I just had a lot of hate, I think, to myself and to the world. And boxing gave me an outlet to feel better about it. Yeah. once I did the boxing, I did that for 2 years. And then I kind of left it because I thought, you know, my friends and having a girlfriend and that sort of thing were more important. I didn't have that outlet anymore to be able to kind of express myself and my anxieties and my frustrations and a lot of the anger and the trauma that I think I had. So my dad has always been in the gym. My parents have always been in the gym. So finally I took him up on it and he started like helping me and coaching me. And I think for me, when I found powerlifting, it was like, wow, nobody cares about the color of my skin. Nobody cares about whether I'm poor, I'm rich. Like, nobody cares about my background, my religion, nothing. You know, all the politics, everything, put it all to the side. The only thing that people care about is like, hey, you know, are you in the gym? Are you being consistent? Are you lifting? Are you hitting PRs? Are you having a good time? And so that was when I realized lifting very quickly became the answer to my kind of like my frustrations and my anxieties and my depression. At this point, you know, I've been powerlifting exactly 10 years now. You know, in the beginning, you're really wrapped up about like, oh, the numbers and like, oh my God, like, you know, fanboying over like, oh, that's my idol. And like, I think I quickly started realizing now, like over the years, especially as I started like directing meets, was that like, I'm like, wow, you know, I can really change people's lives in a different way. Basically, this is an outlet that facilitates community and positive support. The culture that we've created that exists today is, you know, it's something that didn't happen by accident. It's something that's been very meticulous, like, and very consistent and persistent over the past, it's gonna be almost 8 years now. For me, it was about building that culture. You know, if you feel comfortable here, you feel at home, then absolutely 100%, you know, like join the gym, be a part of the gym. We're pretty easygoing and we try to make people feel comfortable. Yeah, we got a lot of really nice equipment and it's all competition grade, but you'll come for the equipment, but you'll stay for the people. I'm not a perfect man, but I try to be the best person that I can, the best role model that I can, especially for all like the younger lifters, like kind of getting started now. And I think you can see that in the gym where everybody respects each other. You know, I always tell people the three things I look for are humility, respect, and giving back.
It's a type of community that kind of feels like family. I remember the first day I got here, I only knew like one or two people, and now it's like, I kind of know, I ain't gonna say I know everybody, But it really has that family oriented feel. Like if somebody, for example, somebody may be going for like a heavy squat, which happened today, there's always people there to help you with spotting or helping out with loading the weights or helping people warm up, stretch, things of that nature. So it's kind of like really community driven. It really makes you feel welcome and at home. Nobody here really feels like nervous. They all really feel like they can be themselves here.
They will welcome you with open arms, no matter how strong you are.
I would say at first I was initially afraid to come work out here because I was under the impression like only like big people come here, people who are like really strong, but I'd say you see all different kinds of people here and I'm not really intimidated anymore. And I would just say it's just a welcoming environment.
The environment here just felt like a very tight-knit community, a very welcoming environment. The vibes, the people, the gym, it just felt like a place where I wanted to be at.
I sign everybody up personally, so I know every single person that signs up. You know, I know most of the guests that come in here, so I really do make an effort to be personal with my business because I understand that's really important to our community and our members, and it's also likewise very important to me that I feel connected with my people. Can I look at one of these cameras? Like if I were to, or look at that one? Yeah, that's fine. You know, if and this is something that I've really tried to do more recently by trying to like, you know, like serve others is, if you're going through something, like definitely don't be afraid to reach out. That's literally like what I try to make myself available for, you know, to try to like help other people. It's, I know what it's like to come from struggle, and I know what it's like to deal with depression, anxiety, and all of these things. And I think a lot of the times, you know, we feel like we're alone. We feel like there's nobody out there that has ever experienced this or has dealt with this. And, you know, the truth is there's so many people out there that have probably felt the same way that you do or have experienced something. And, like, it's okay to feel that way. So, you know, I think, like, what I've learned is that I like using my platform to be able to, you know, show others like, hey, you know, you can be successful, but still like, you know, deal with some of these issues and basically still be a human being. So if you're going through anything, if you're struggling with anything, you know, don't be afraid to reach out or send me a DM, give me a call, shoot me a text. Like, I get busy, but I always get back to my people, to my members, and always take care of you guys.